Hi, I'm Danny. Welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'll go over cooling fans and how they work. I'll do this on my 2007 Honda Element. If your fans aren't coming on or your engine is overheating, hopefully this video will help you with that problem. Let's start by going over a couple of things that'll cause your vehicle to overheat. Then I'll jump right into how the fans work. Let's get started. Never remove the radiator cap on a warm engine. The coolant is under pressure and it's very hot. You will get burned. So always check the coolant level when the engine is cold. The coolant needs to be clean and at the proper level. If your coolant is low, you'll need to top it off before you go any further. If your coolant has oil in it or your oil has coolant in it, that's going to be more of an engine problem, and I'm not covering that in this video. You'll also want to check for codes. If your vehicle has codes, that's where you need to start first. Let me give you a quick overview of the fans and how they work on my 2007 Honda Element. The fans are actually controlled by the computer. There's also sensors, relays, switches, and wiring. But don't worry about that. I'll simplify the diagnostic procedure for you. The fans should come on whenever the ignition is turned on and the AC switch is on. The reason for this is it helps create airflow through the condenser, and that helps your AC system blow cold, especially when your vehicle's at a stop. When the AC is not on, the fans will come on when the engine reaches temperatures around 212 degrees, and then they'll shut back off when it hits normal operating temperature. The computer is always trying to maintain a normal operating temperature. This is determined by the manufacturer of that vehicle. I'm pretty sure it's an emissions thing. A quick way to test the fans is to turn on the AC with the ignition in the run position. Both fans should come on. If they do, that checks the wiring, relays, and the fans for proper operation. If one or both fans don't come on when the AC is on and the ignition is in the run position, watch my video, Air Conditioning Blows Warm at Stops, Fans Not Working Honda Element. This is on my YouTube channel. That video goes over the diagnostic procedure of this scenario. If the fans do come on with the AC on, but don't come on when the AC is off and the engine is above 212 degrees, you'll need to check the engine coolant temperature sensor number 2 and the wiring for proper operation. Let me show you the easiest way to do this.
All right, so let me show you what's going on. I've got a jumper wire and it goes to my negative side of the battery. So this is just to get a good ground. So the jumper wire comes all the way down to my meter here, and it plugs into the comm side of my meter. And then I've got the voltage side here, and I've actually got a nice sharp back probe right here. And then over here, I've got this panel down. It's actually pretty easy to pull down and makes things a lot easier. And then there's the clips. If you break some, I can put a link on Amazon where you can get these. But let me show you what I'm doing as far as the sensor. Let me come over here, come underneath.
There's two engine coolant temperature sensors, or ECT sensors. This one is called ECT sensor number 2, and it controls your fans. ECT sensor number 1, that one controls fuel and timing, and that one's up top. I'm only worried about this one. The computer supplies 5 volts to the green wire at the sensor. The voltage then goes through the ECT sensor, and as the coolant temperature increases, that 5 volt signal decreases. Once the voltage decreases enough, the fans will come on. My first step is to see if the computer is supplying the 5 volts to the connector on the green wire.
So we're going to go ahead and remove the connector. And then it's just a tab right here that you kind of push down and you pull it straight out.
All right, so I've got my meter lead connected inside the connector. And it's front probed right there. And the meter is actually showing the 5 volts. So we're getting the voltage from the computer to that sensor.
Now that I know the computer is sending the 5 volts to the sensor, I'll back probe that green wire. Then I'll start the engine. The resistance in that sensor will decrease, and so will the voltage as the coolant warms up. Once the voltage drops near 0 volts, the fan should come on. And if they do, the system is working properly.
So what I'm going to do is back probe this green wire. And then we're going to take a look at my meter. And we're going to see the voltage change as I start it. So before I start it, I'm going to show you my meter. It says 3 volts. And the temperature of the coolant right now, if you can see it, it's 79 degrees Fahrenheit. So let's go ahead and start the engine. So right now it's 162 degrees and the voltage is still holding at 2.97. All right, so I'm at 212, the fan should come on. 0.56 on the voltage on the meter. So both fans are on. They should run for just a minute or two just to cool it off, and they just shut off. So that's how the properly functioning fan should work. See, now it's cooling it down. And then once it hits right about 212 again, the fans would come back on.
I've seen a couple people jump that connector with a paperclip. On the Honda Element, it doesn't work. The computer just thinks that's a short to ground and it'll set a code. If you're going to replace that sensor, you'll need to do it on a cold engine. And remember, you're going to lose a lot of coolant, so it might be a good time to change your coolant. If you need to know how to change your coolant, I do have a video on that, and I'll put a link in the description. I hope you got something out of this video today. I don't have a problem with my Honda Element. I was just showing you some known good readings. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up. Consider subscribing. More videos on the way. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.